the length of film. And this is, there's two functions to this fairly brief lecture. One is that it's an option for you to take it within your documentary filmmaking project. You can make this one of your, the form of your project. You can make a video essay or something called an essay film. I'm going to talk about what either of those things are. And I'm going to go through them in a little bit of detail, but mostly through showing you what they are and how they've changed over the past. The words to describe or talk about it are the same thing as the thing that it is, words. So there's a match there, isn't there? You can literally take a quote from a book, put it in the text of a piece of film criticism. That makes a difference, doesn't it? And I think that's why film criticism is sort of flawed, it's because it's not visual, it's not about the medium itself. This form bridges that, doesn't it? It's film criticism that's filmic. That makes it interesting. It's an audio-visual essay. Whatever essay means, we'll talk about that in a bit. Well, it could be. They've become things of mainstream now. Video essays, there's a whole batch of them on BBC, iPlayer, and the Inside Cinema Ballad. These are very good, by the way. There's loads of them. Number 96, there's 96 to enjoy. Various discussions had. Informative, it's educational, they're enjoyable. It comes to gain control of them, like children. Olivia put her down, and then she knows what's going on. I just have to say Olivia. And you gain control over it. Name it, give it control, stand up. Obviously, whatever it is. Shakespearean things, the fun to himself. He makes the Wind one, which I thought it's going on here. It's on Netflix as well, so I think in a minute. He makes F for Fake, one of the finest essay films ever made. You should watch that if you can. And then does a load of adverts for Brandy. He lives, there was a joke that Orson Welles lived his career backwards, that he started making adverts. And then progressed up into these smaller films about Shakespeare. They made Magnificent Amazons, and then ended with his masterpiece. This is okay, that's where he should have happened. But he did it completely backwards. He's obsessed with it. talks about, so he does about the film A Year, Mark Cousins, all on his own, him and the camera. These are essay films, long-form documentaries, but with a very personal, subjective flavour. I think it's worth looking at. He's also encyclopedically endowed with film knowledge. He knows everything about film. Has a lovely attitude towards it. And then the next film is Fear Itself, by Charlie Ryan, now Charlie Shackleton, who made Beyond Clueless, which was on Netflix for a short time, which was an essay compilation film about teenage high school films. It's a lovely film, it's a beautiful film. And then he made another one later on with BBC, Fear Itself, which is about horror, the horror genre. And it's really a journey, a personal journey of his love of horror and all the scenes within it that sort of means to him as a person growing up and also as a film critic and writer. It has a weird structure. Obviously, lots and lots of clips, films that people know, horror films. And over the top of that is written a very highly dramatised version of his views, because he has somebody else play him. So he writes a script that's sort of his, but it's the words that you hear are the words of a teenage American girl talking about going to the mall and watching these movies, and you hear her voice talking about what you saw. So he's in fact a London-based male young man, gay, young British man, not at all young American girl. So he's clumped it all into a strange world in which, for whatever reason. So he's done that with Beyond Clueless as well. It really works. You can do some research to find out why he did that. I think it's interesting. I think partly it's hiding away as an author, but also it's to add a different flavour, because lots of the films that he likes are American films. So he writes as in a different character. That definitely blurs the line between fact and fiction. Dean Century philosopher, who kept a book called A Commonplace Book, which all his thoughts and feelings and experiences and ruminations were laid down. He'd go for walks, see a cat at the bottom of a tree, he would observe a bird falling from the tree, and he would go, "Oh, that's funny," and then write about it. We'd write about death, stuff like that. He'd observe a quarrel from his neighbours about something, and then he would write something about quarrelling. Something like that. Philosophical about the things that he sees. Those got turned into his publication called The Essays, and that's when the essay was invented then, and now it's become this thing. But the word essay comes from the word to attempt, to try,